I'm replacing the coolant on my 2017 Honda Accord, and I decided to try one of these spill-proof coolants. This is my first time using one of these, and I wanted to see how it compares to the traditional way of filling up and bleeding air from your cooling system. Now let's get this. I'm using Prestone Max, made for Asian vehicles, as it has the same specs for the Honda Blue Lifelong coolant, but costs a lot less. Links are in the description if you want to check it out. First thing is to move my drain pan under the car and then crack open the radiator drain plug, and to make the flow faster, I remove the radiator cap. While that's draining, I also remove the coolant reservoir, dump the coolant that is there, and then use the opportunity to give it a thorough clean. I reinstall it, and for this procedure, I'm going to be filling it up to the max line even before we start filling up the radiator. Now this spill-proof funnel comes with several adapters to cover a lot of cars, and you're going to be needing one of these yellow ones and a cap. Just pick the yellow one that fits inside the inner lip of your radiator opening. The idea is that this rubber here provides a perfect seal with this inner lip, and then for the right adapter cap, just find the one that looks exactly like your radiator cap. This one matches exactly the shape and dimensions of my existing radiator cap. Coolant is fully drained, and while you don't need to do this next step, I just decided to pour some deionized water just to rinse off the radiator. I won't be flushing the cooling system using distilled water, since I'm not going to be draining the block. I don't want to dilute the coolant. With all of that drained, I tighten the radiator plug, and then for the front part, which is filling up this car took around 1 full gallon and then some from the second container. You want to continue adding coolant until you stop having air bubbles come up, and then at that point you want to fill the funnel about 1/3 of the way up. Next is to start the car, turn the heat to max. That ensures that the valves to the heater core will be opened. It's essential to make sure that your AC is off. If the AC is on, it's going to slow down the car getting to operating temperature. And in fact, you want to hold the car at fast idle so that it gets to operating temperature quicker. And for that, I'm using the case of my torque wrench and holding the RPM at 2000. Now you can see some air bubbles coming up and coolant is going down to take its place. Air in the cooling system can cause overheating and can also make your car not to produce heat from the AC vents. You'll continue to hold the RPM at 2000 until the car reaches operating temperature. You're going to know that the car has reached operating temperature in one of these two ways. First is that the cooling fans are going to come on at least twice. Secondly, the lower radiator hose, which was initially cold, is going to become as hot as the top radiator hose. Once this happens, you're going to see a lot more bubbles and become a tad more violent, especially if you drain the block. So be sure not to stay directly opposite the funnel. Once this happens, you can drop the RPM back down to idle and then continue to idle the car until you don't see any more bubbles. At this point, insert the stopper into the funnel and discharge what's left back into your coolant container. You can then shut the car off. Here I'm using a cloth because of the heat to remove the adapter cap, and afterwards I reinstall the radiator cap. Because we filled up the coolant reservoir, as the vehicle cools down and the coolant contracts in the radiator, it's going to draw in coolant from the reservoir. Finally, allow the car to cool down completely, and as you can see here, the reservoir is a bit short while the radiator is still full. Top off the reservoir, make sure it's between the min and the max. This tool is definitely one good addition to my toolbox. Previously, I need to do at least 2 bleeding cycles, turning on the car, idling, then filling up, and so on. But it's nice to do this once and for all. Hope this has been helpful. Do like, share, subscribe, and turn on notifications if it has. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.